dreams and sin inside the hourglass. Mainly concerned back in the day with how long I would last. Make a few $1,000 stack with every hour pass. I catch you playing inside my lane and I'ma foul your ass. Put the whole game on top of my back, don't need no chiropract. They calling me young PWC, I got my power back. Ain't fucking around beefing with me, gon' get you hollered at. Niggas can't see me one-on-one, that's where the collar crack. You hitting them weights, congratulations, cause you built something. You taking a lot of boxing lessons, but you still pussy.
We have a lot of updating to do. I don't know what I'm gonna call this prep series, but we're getting ready for another IPF Worlds. I know a couple videos back I talked about how I would no longer be competing in IPF Worlds due to the suspension of the USAPL, but through some loopholes, I'm gonna be competing with the US Virgin Islands, and I will be appearing at this year's IPF World Championship. And it's kind of weird because like this is one of the most confusing, somewhat mentally stressful types of preps. Like, we were, what, 4 to 5 weeks out? That's usually when you begin the peak. And we had no idea if I was gonna be able to compete in IPF Worlds. And a situation presented itself about a week and a half ago. Took it. And as of maybe a couple of days ago, it has been finalized and we'll be heading over to Sweden. So it's kind of like rush hour. We're rushing to get ready for this meet. I have to like kind of restate my mindset in terms of what I want to accomplish at this Worlds competition. So we're just jumping back into it and just trying to get that feeling back. And today was one of those sessions where it's like you feel prep. I felt that a little bit last week, but it definitely hit this week. And it's interesting because last week we hit 700 and I want to say 717 or 712 or something around that on single for squat. So then today we came in and hit 705 pounds. I had a certain number that I wanted to hit, but you know, didn't culminate in today's workout, but it's crazy to know that we could hit 705 pounds kind of casually. But a lot of stuff going on. Still prepping for Worlds. Still trying to keep that mindset alive as to becoming the repeat world champion in the A3 kg weight class. So it's time to lock in. I mean, 3 weeks away from flying out to Sweden and grabbing another world championship. So welcome to the prep series leading into IPF Worlds 2021. What's up guys, last time I talked to you, it was Tuesday, and following Tuesday's squat session, I actually went and got the vaccine. Now, I don't know if it's gonna like shadow ban me or whatever, but I wanted to show the entirety of this journey just to show you guys like the lengths at which I'm going to in order to compete in Sweden. So it wasn't like I was anti-vax or anything like that. I just decided that the easiest path of resistance or the least path of resistance is to get the vaccine just in case I get stopped at the border or anything like that. When you do have the vaccine, it makes it easier to travel. So I want to eliminate as much stress as possible when it comes to that process, because this whole thing is stressful in itself. I don't know. I didn't know if I was gonna be able to compete. I didn't know about the whole travel situation. Training is like up and down here and there because we don't know what's going on. I don't know if I have to change my programming to compete later on in the year or what. But once again, got the vaccine in order to make the whole process a little bit more simple. Now, when I got the vaccine, as you guys know that have taken the shot, it completely knocked my ass out. So Wednesday was just like a scratch. I didn't even come to the gym, which is very rare for myself because I never make excuses to not pull up. But I decided yesterday it's best if I just rest and save my energy for today's session and combine the two. So we already knocked down deadlift. I hit 733 pounds for the single, which is amazing. A little bit of overshooting, but at the same time, still 733 pounds being 3 weeks out from the platform. Now we're going to be combining Wednesday session, and we're going to knock down probably 2 to 3 sets on bench. We only have 4 reps. We're just trying to get the work in because we missed yesterday's session, and then we'll get back on it Friday. So let's knock it out. As you guys can see, we got the SBD stuff on. I'm contractually obligated to wear SBD on the platform. It's not bad though. It's pretty cool. You know what I'm saying? So this is the singlet. Got the shirt. Didn't put on the socks, but this is basically what I'm gonna be wearing on the platform. Okay, so we're back. We took yesterday off because yesterday wasn't that interesting. I had some errands to run. Ended up not being able to run those errands. So I went to go buy a suit. Let me give you guys like the real. I went to go buy a suit. I wanted to start wearing a suit like for weigh-ins. And I don't know why my dumbass thought I could actually go into like a suit store and just get something off the rack and get it tailored. Like the guy was like, man, I'm not even gonna lie to you, man. Like the way your body is structured, your musculature would not allow us to give you a suit off the rack. The alteration that we'd have to make, you should just get a full tailored suit. That's gonna take about 3 weeks for it to get ready. And I was like, I don't have 3 weeks. I got about a week and a half. And he's like, can't do anything for you. So that's where we're at. I think the last thing that I have to do is get a top part for my grill. That's about it. But we are less than 3 weeks out from competing on the actual platform and about 2 weeks out from flying out. And then we are also 2 weeks out from the biggest GBT launch of the year. So a lot of different moving parts. I'm gonna be jumping into my singlet. You guys saw me train that 2 days ago because it is now time to be wearing the singlet. I have my full kit from SBD that I have to wear on the platform. And for those of you that are new to the channel, I have to wear this singlet because, I start wearing the singlet because I need to be hammering technique, making sure I'm hitting depth, making sure that when I bench with my singlet on, my butt is coming off the bench. And then deadlift, making sure that everything's locked out when I do lock out. So that's the purpose of the singlet, just to make sure that we're cleaning up the technical aspects of lifting and try and get as specific and mimic game day as much as we possibly can. So let's jump into the singlet. We got squats today. It's gonna be a really, really easy session. And then we're gonna go back home, chill out, and rinse and repeat for next week. So I'll see you guys in the gym. You already know what to do. Run that shit.
Yeah. Whoa. Whoa. I'm too sexy for this sir. Too sexy for your girl. Too sexy for this world. Too sexy for this ice. Too sexy for that jack. Yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for this chain. Too sexy for your game. Too sexy for this fame. Yeah, yeah. Okay, alright, that's fine. Okay. Okay. Feeling too sexy to accept requests.
Way too sexy.
And I'm way too sexy to go unprotected.
Way too sexy.
And she probably says that.
Okay guys, that's gonna conclude episode 1. I still don't have a name for the series, but we're gonna be building up for IPF World. So the videos coming out going forward are gonna be the process of which it takes in order to get ready to step on the platform of the world stage. There's a lot of uncertainty, like I mentioned earlier at the beginning of the video. There's so many reasons to not do this meet, but We're honing in on our craft. We're focusing on what we can control, and we're trying to reestablish that mindset going into IPF Worlds. I mean, I have my boy Josh with me, like my brother. Then we got Jay in here hyping me up. Like, there's some times when I come into this session, I'm like, I don't feel like lifting today. You know what I'm saying? But I got the homies like hyping me up, reminding me like why I'm doing this, reminding me to keep my mind on what's at task. Like, we're here to be the best at the best in the world, right? Like, there's not too many motherfuckers that can say they're best at what they do in the whole entire world. And I have the opportunity to prove that. So if I'm given the opportunity, I'm gonna do whatever I can in order to make that to happen. So that's gonna do it for today's video. Please make sure that you guys are subscribed and hit that notification bell whenever I drop a video. I've been getting a lot of comments on Instagram about people haven't been notified whenever I drop a video, or they haven't seen any of my videos in a while. So that's gonna be it. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Like always, like today's video. Please like, comment, share, subscribe. Be better today. Too sexy for this fame. Yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for the trap.